authorizations using Basic on Node.js. Let's start. So we open Visual Studio Code and we do npm init to generate the bucket.json file. And then we install the library called Express. There we go. Now we start to create a file called app.js. This is our main project file. So do app.js, okay? And there we go. We start to write our code here. First, we create an object called app by require the express library and then put a parenthesis at the end. After that, we define the endpoint. Let's say we want to get a list of user. We pass the callback function with request and response. There we go. So in the request, we try to get the authorization info by calling request.header.authorization. There we go. We can do a console log to see, you know, what authorization value we receive. Okay? And after that, we do, let's say, we respond and send list of user. Okay? After that, we listen at the port default 3000. Let's start our app and test. We open the postman, and in the postman, we try to get a list of user. In the authorization, we put basic, and in the basic, we put admin and the admins. And let's run it. We return list of user, and we go back to the console here. We see that we receive actually a string called basic and a space and the base 64 encode. So we have to decode this one to get a username and password and compare that username and password with our username and password in a database or hardcoded username and password, you know, in a memory. So we do that by, let's say we want to get a user and pass from here. So what we do is we say authorizations and split. We split it by a space and we only get the second part, so one. We can even do the console log to see, but it's not important. So now we'll try to use functions to decode this one into a plain text. So plain text will be, we'll use a function called buffer and from user pass, and this encode is by 64. Now we convert it into string using ASCII. There we go. Now we will decode the plain text. After decoding the by 64, we have plain text. So we pass the username and password from plain text. So what we do is we use split, and in that split, we split by the colons, and the first part will be the username, and the second part will be the password. So we do exactly the same here. There we go. So now we compare. If username equals admin and password equals admin, we will respond a message say, okay, this is a list of user. If it's not correct, then we'll respond a message saying that authentication required. Okay, and then let's try to run it again. We open the postman and then run. So, correct username and password, list of user. But if we put a wrong username and password, it will say authentication required. Okay, there we go. So, let's try to do a little bit more. So we will use what we call middleware. We define a middleware, let's say auth10 or auth. And in this middleware is actually a function. And in that function, we have request, respond, and then next. Okay? So we put everything here. So now we try to compare. If username and password equal to this, we will call next. And then if not correct, we will reject by sending a message called authenticate required, for example. Okay, so in here we'll try to use this middleware by calling app.useAuth. Okay, and this will be just the normal function. We don't have to worry about, you know, authentication anymore because we delegate this into the middleware. So let's try again. Now try to say yes, authentication required, but if we put a correct username password, it's return list of user. Thank you.